In this video, we will take a look at an interesting algorithm usually taught to students who are just starting to learn algorithms and their complexity. Developing an algorithm to search an element in a sorted array using binary search. Binary search is one of the faster search algorithms with a runtime complexity of big O of log base 2 of n, where n is the number of characters or number of items in the array. To understand what big O of log n means, please search for that topic in our channel. Binary search algorithm works on the principle of divide and conquer. As you will learn in a few moments, that this algorithm divides the sorted array or list in almost equal parts at each iteration while discarding one and working on only the other half. One of the assumptions about data for using the binary search algorithm is that the data collection should be in a sorted form, whether ascending or descending. In addition, the algorithm needs to know whether the collection is sorted in ascending order or descending order so that it can decide which half of the collection to discard on each iteration. Given a collection sorted in an ascending order, the binary search algorithm will look for a particular item by comparing the item sitting at the center of the collection with the item we are looking for. If a match occurs, then the index of this item will be returned. If the middle item is greater than the item being searched, then the item is further searched in the subarray to the left of the middle item. Otherwise, the item is searched in the subarray to the right of the middle item. Same process continues on the selected subarray as well, until the size of the subarray reduces to zero. Let's look at an example. Assume that we have a collection of 20 items sorted in ascending order. The item we are looking for is somewhere in the third quarter of this collection. Of course, our algorithm does not know that at this time. The algorithm of the binary search will look for the item at the center of this sorted collection. If the collection size is 100, the middle item or one of the closest to the middle item would be at position number 50. If the collection size is 21, the middle item would be at position number 11. To solve this problem of whether our collection has an exact middle or not, we use a common practice to use either the floor or ceiling of the value calculated by dividing the total number of items in the collection by 2. Whether we use floor or ceiling does not really matter. However, our algorithm will need to know which one we are using to be able to properly set the starting and ending index of the subarray in which to search during the next iteration. Let's get back to the execution of our algorithm. For our 20-item collection, we were looking for an item that was somewhere in the third quarter of the collection. We checked the item at position number 10. The item we were looking for was greater than the item at position number 10. So we discarded the subarray to the left of position number 10, including the position number 10 since we already checked it. Now we look at the middle of the subarray to the right of position number 10. The middle item of this subarray is at position 15. Upon comparison, we find that this is not the item we were looking for. However, it is greater than the item we are looking for. This time, we discard the subarray to the right of position 15, including this position since we have already checked it. We move on to the subarray to the left of this position. The middle item of this subarray is at position 12. Upon comparison, we find that this is not the item we were looking for. However, it is greater than the item we are looking for. This time, we discard the subarray to the right of position 12, including this position since we have already checked it. We move on to the subarray to the left of this position. You will notice that this subarray has only one item in it. When our algorithm looks at the item sitting at the middle of this one item subarray, it will find the item we were looking for. Our search is complete. We found our item in 4 steps for a collection of 20 items. This is also the worst case scenario since we kept dividing the collection until only one item was left. If you calculate log base 2 of 20, you will find out that it is slightly higher than 4. Hence, our worst case scenario was close to our estimate of the complexity of this algorithm. for a collection of 500 elements, in a worst case scenario, this algorithm will find the item in 9 or lesser steps. Let's take a look at our iterative algorithm at work one last time. We hope you enjoyed this video. We will continue to add more tutorials in our channel. If you want us to create a tutorial for a specific challenge, leave us a comment and we will add it to our list. Subscribe and tell your friends. Keep learning and keep coding.